let me come to John. John, how do you rank India when it comes to your portfolio returns, dollar adjusted? Because L&T Finance, you made some returns. Hero Motor Corp, you had. Genpact partly. And some others which are probably reaching that fruition.
Yeah, we've been, I mean, our return profile in India and Asia has been terrific and consistent with developed market returns. And frankly, we have to underwrite to slightly higher returns in depreciating currency markets. So we generally do, as Amit said already, put some form of premium on the expectation for longer term currency depreciation. When we look at what our strategy is, it's not just about an asset play over a short period of time. It's, are we seeing partnerships with management? Are we seeing the value addition of how we can grow earnings differentially? And how do we actually look at the M&A and business development opportunity even outside of India for those companies? And I think that those metrics makes us believe that this is a really terrific market for our strategy for private equity, not just a momentum strategy.
So your Asia 4 fund is raising funds right now. How big is that fund going to be, and how much could really make it to India?
Well, we have targeted about $3.5 billion of funds, and frankly, our first fund was $1 billion, our second fund was $2 billion, our third fund was $3 billion. So we're not just trying to raise the absolute largest size fund, but we are trying to deploy an increasingly higher amount in all of our geographies. That's one of the reasons why India has gone up in investment velocity over the last 5 years, is our fund size has gotten larger. We've built a team, we have more track record. And so when we get to the higher level of 3.5, and it may be close at a higher amount, there's an excess demand for that fund. There's a lot of investor interest in our platform. We will see the velocity grow up accordingly for India. It's not in a given year. We look at it over the cycle of a 4 or 5 year investment period, because the volatility will still be there.
We are not very predictable. We do invest in market leaders. And because those land up being big, large deals, our business is a little bit more easier to predict over a large cycle than actually over short cycles.
So to that point, I have two questions to ask. Is it being overcautious when it comes to investments, and therefore you have a small portfolio here in India? Or on the other hand, your ticket size is so large for each transaction that it is restrictive?
Yeah, I think that the element of what's most important to us is the applicability of what we can do to support a management team. And so when you talk about scale opportunities, they just have more opportunities to go after adjacencies and growth. They have better management talent to go after market share gains or expansions in other geographies. And so smaller companies just generally don't have the same type of resource capabilities that I think the larger companies do. And so when we look at our strategy, some of these larger companies just have the ability to do more with them than some of the smaller companies.
So Amit, where are you spending most of your time? Of course, your core areas are financial services, IT, BPO, industrials, and you have consumption as well as TMT also.
And healthcare, I would say.
And healthcare.
Yes.
So which is the area which is taking up most of your time?
I would say all those areas, because for us, we tend to take a 4-5 year view on exactly all those verticals, and then, not really focus on everything else. And it does become difficult to be predictive on what exactly will happen in which year in any of those spaces.
What's looking attractive?
Well, at this point of time, actually, some of the things which have sold off are actually the ones which are looking most attractive. So, we are spending a lot of time on healthcare because, it has, it has gone out of favor a little bit. And financials are beginning to look attractive again, as are industrials.
All right. So, John, you have done a lot of work in the pharma healthcare space. Now, you have Emcure in your India portfolio. Now, pretty much most of the pharma companies have been plagued by the US FDA concerns in India. How do you, from outside, view this sector right now?
Well, we have done a lot of generics, life sciences, CROs, clinical research organizations, and I think we're seeing quite a revolution in how the marketplace looks at all these companies, but also how they're evolving their business models. And we're seeing the marketplace become much more global. There's a life science revolution going on in each of the major geographies, in the developed world, in the US, in Europe. We're seeing it in China. And certainly India has always been a big part of that ecosystem, particularly around the generics business. So our view is the regulatory marketplace is beginning to harmonize around a view of what it takes to actually get drugs approved in each of these markets, but it's becoming more similar as opposed to what it used to be, which is quite distinct. And so if you want to be successful as a as an Indian generics player, you've got to be successful on the global marketplace. And we're seeing the capabilities of the India generics companies get better and better and adopt some of the practices, and the credibility of the FDA in looking at that will also go up in kind.
So many healthcare opportunities are available here. Are that those attracting you at this point?
Yeah, I think we've continued to spend a lot of time in the sector generally because, you know, as John mentioned, healthcare is actually one of our biggest verticals globally. Even recently in Europe, we closed one of our biggest healthcare investments, Tata, good indicator of, you know, our interest in the space more broadly. And so even in India, we continue to spend a lot of time in this segment. I mean, it is a very interesting segment, and Indian companies have actually come a long way in building capability, not just India, but India-centric capability to service global markets. Mm-hmm. And so that space is one of deep interest to us.
What's really evolving also fast, and you can get some learnings because you're ahead in the learning curve overseas than India, is the whole data explosion, automation, artificial intelligence. You have some IT BPO investments like Genpact Quest and Big Data Center as well. Now, how do you see that opportunity developing in India? Is that an area where you would like to spend time on?
Well, yeah, I mean, I think that certainly, I mean, healthcare specifically, if you want to even narrow it to the impact of those types of digital transformations in healthcare, has been huge. And certainly the value-based payment systems that we see evolving in the U.S. marketplace are all based on not just doing the service, but doing it with a high-quality outcome that you can track and get paid for. And so the clinical quality associated with what you do in a medical procedure is becoming much more digitally oriented, much more tracked, and the protocols are going to be similar, and you're only going to get paid for the outcome. And so when we look at sort of what we're doing in the U.S., and frankly, even in other emerging markets, even Brazil, we have huge amounts of data to support the decision-making of our clinical delivery system. And so that's going to be a huge transformation.
So Amit, at this point, entry mode, exit mode, or wait and watch?
No, I think, you know, given our business model, we are generally always looking at doing both. You know, it's important for us, you know, to always be nimble in looking at monetizing investments. That's been a learning looking at the journey for the last 10 years. You know, and so we do look at taking chips off the table as and when investments are mature. But at the same time, you know, when we raise new funds, we are constantly looking for opportunities. And so, you know, the team is constantly focused on both sets of things.
Is Himadri Chemicals also gearing up for an exit then?
You know, Himadri Chemicals is, in fact, doing excellently at this point of time, as you would have. They've had a record quarter just recently. But yes, it's in its seventh year, you know, now. And at some point of time, we'll have to decide what we want to do with it.
Is market volatility a dampener for taking these decisions right now?
You see, as a responsible shareholder, we always think very hard about what's the right time to take our decisions. And, you know, obviously, when you see a lot of volatility, you decide, you take a call on what's the right time to press the button for any investment.